Hello everyone, PallyTime here. Welcome back to the World of Warcraft. We find ourselves in Orgrimmar today. Very iconic city to the Horde. Let's see, what do I know about Orgrimmar? I know that it was founded by Thrall, and I hope that's accurate. I really do. I hope that's accurate. The zone that it's in is Durotar, which was named after Thrall's dad, Durotan. At one point, the fire elementals got real mad and actually burned a decent portion of the city. What we see now in the city is what Gazlo, hey, it's Gazlo, everybody's favorite goblin, came back in and rebuilt and made real nice. Or at least nicer. My friend Kai calls this place a city of metal, where before it used to just be a pile of sticks. Now it's just a pile of metal. There is a dungeon located here. And basically, this is the capital of the Horde. This is where everybody goes. If you want to AFK somewhere, you're probably going to do it in Orgrimmar. It's one of the top places, I would say. As you can see, a lot of Zeppelins come into this place. There's one to the left of my character right now. We have the one we came in on. This one goes to Thunderbluff. This one here goes to the Borean Tundra. Oh, that's where the Lich King and all that Arthas stuff is going on at. This goes to the Undercity, Tirith's Fall, and then the other side goes to Booty Bay. So you can get to a lot of places just by venturing into Orgrimmar. It's a pretty cool place. A pretty cool place. We are going to make our way down off this tower. First of all, I want to start out by saying that I apologize for the break in episodes. I think my conservative goal is to get three of these out a week, and I would really like to try to stick to that, and I would try to get three of these episodes out a week. In a perfect world, I would do a lot more, and I want to do a lot more. But, you know, we'll kind of see what the schedule allows me to do. God, he's so handsome. Look at him. Just so handsome. So one of the cool things you can do if you're on a new character is actually, you can get a really easy achievement right here for those of you that are achievement hunters, collectors, and such. You can just kind of jump off right about here. You'll hit the ground, you'll have about 3 HP, and you'll be able to get the going down achievement, or at least that's what I think it's called. Also, for those of you that are interested, there are a decent amount of quartermasters up here. So we have the Darkspear Quartermaster, the Bilgewater Cartel, that's the Goblins, and then the Orgrimmar Quartermaster. You can go up to these guys and buy their tabards, which, yeah, whatever. We're already here. I'll go ahead and do that. And this will allow me to build up their reputation later on, whenever I go in and do dungeons and stuff. It's pretty cool. I suppose I should go a little bit more in depth with that, huh? Why would you build up your reputation with these guys? Well, because you can get some pretty cool mounts. For instance, with actually they're riding on the mounts that you can get for the most part, except for this one. If you build up your reputation with the Darkspear, if you go into dungeons wearing their tabard and just fight in their honor, you'll actually gain access to that raptor. If you do it for Orgrimmar, if you do it for the orcs, you gain the wolf. And then you can ride around on those things. The textures on these are starting to look pretty outdated, though. I hope they go back and redo those soon. Anyway, going down achievement, let's get it. I don't believe I have it already, so it should be fairly easy to do. We are currently level 13. Hey, I got my achievement after I logged back in. I was so good at it that they made me do, like, they made sure I wasn't cheating when I fell. That's what they were going for, I think. I'm trying to hide my UI elements. So let's take a quick look around Orgrimmar. It's actually a pretty cool city. To the left here, there's the auction house, for those of you that didn't know. You can go up to the goblins over there, stereotyping goblins already here, and sell all your stuff on the auction house. Usually the most densely populated area. But hey, it's looking okay today. You can see some members of the TGN Squadron hanging around here. The Viewer Guild is going quite well. We have 436 total members. It's actually ridiculous. I was not expecting to have that many. Thank you all for wanting to come in and share your experiences with me. I am playing a shaman as well, for those of you that didn't know. Over here, this is the bank. Once again, goblins. I guess we're just making them do anything that has to do with storage and money. I'll go ahead and put those tabbers in there. We'll save those for later. Now, we do have a quest to carry out while we are here. We were sent by Bane Bloodhoof. We were sent over here to talk with the current war chief to let them know that we were still going to help out in Thunderbluff, or at least that's the gist of what I think was going on. Let's read it one more time. Take the mark of Bloodhoof to the war chief located in Gromash Hold in Orgrimmar. You may speak to Tall the Windright. We already did that. Much has changed outside of Mulgore Palytime. The world is torn, and our horde allies have been turned down dark paths. We must guide them. Even in the darkest hour, we will bravely hold our heads high and honor the Earth Mother in all we do. You must go, Palytime, and be the example. Go to Orgrimmar. Tell the war chief how the grim totem were driven out. Let them know our pride and discipline, our strength and sorrow. So this is Vol'jin. I don't really know how he became the war chief of the Horde. I don't know how he became kind of the ruler of Orgrimmar. But I'm sure it had something to do with Warlords of Draenor. If you guys would like to let me know down in the comments, I would love to read it. That's been one of my favorite things about doing this series so far. I can kind of piece together all of the lore that I don't actually know. You guys, you know, you give me pieces here and pieces there, and then all of a sudden I have a pretty full picture of what's going on in the world, and I really, really like that. So this is Vol'jin. Let's go ahead and talk to him. What brings ye to me, Paladin? We're going to give him the mark of Bloodhoof. Oh, man, it's even written like that. Ye tell me, da grim totem be force from Mulgore? You must be a fierce warrior to earn the praise of Bane Bloodhoof. I thought so, Mr. Troll guy. The Horde need heroes, one that hold honor in their hearts. Very well, Paladin. I accept ye as one of us. That's how it's written. It's not my fault. For the Horde. Okay. So I'm officially a member of the Horde now, everybody. What's this? Huh. I have no idea where this goes. Well, he has another quest for us, but we can't actually do it. There's another Tauren in here that has a quest from the Earthen Ring. They're trying to send me out to the Barrens, though. I don't think I want to go to the Barrens just yet. There is a few things I wanted to do while I was in town. This episode is going to be a little bit more focused on character development, I think, than the other ones were. Because it's important that we get a profession. That's serious business. Professions are serious business. And they affect the game in a variety of different ways. So there's enchanting that will put this magical essence onto gear. I think that would be the best way of putting it. There's jewel crafting, which would allow you to make these gems that you can socket into gear to make them stronger. There is mining, herbalism, skinning, and encryption, blacksmithing, leatherworking. And I know I'm missing some. There's engineering. I'm sure there's more. But it kind of helps to find what your character does. Look at this badass over here. Look at this badass over here. The red flame, fiery shield, the pimp hat, and red armor. Let's just go ahead and give her a little clap. You look great. Drive-by compliment. Let's get the fuck out of here. Let's get the fuck out of here before she notices. She's just over there eating food and shit. So I was thinking about it, and engineering is one of the most exciting things ever, but I already have an engineer on this server. So I was thinking I would go for jewel crafting because I've never actually done that. And you know, paladins are pretty flashy. They like to show off all their holy light with all their spells and shit. So I thought that would be pretty fun. I do want to see the Horde, the Tauren part of this area. If you look at the map, everything's kind of cut off into their own wings. The Valley of Wisdom over here in Orgrimmar is where all the Tauren hang out. And I thought it'd be cool to go over and look at them. There's actually a quest over here. I wonder what this is. What is going on? Please, mister, you gotta help me. My pa brought a bunch of balloons from the Dark Moon Fair. Best gift ever. Why is he so tall? Can we talk about that really quick? They're magical, you know, and they never lose their floatiness. That sounds awesome. There's just one thing. A big old gust of wind blew them right out of my hands, mister. They scattered all over Orgrimmar. I chased after him myself, but the city's so big I'd get lost for sure. Can you round them up for me before they float away? Please? Okay, so we need to collect balloons for this kid. I'll do that for you, Jaga. For the Horde. We have to give him the little salute. Hold on, let's do it again so you can see. The little salute. That's how he knows we're serious. Serious fucking business. So this is where the Tauren settled. This is pretty cool. I don't really know what they're doing here other than, like, training people. Like, I have no idea what they're doing here. So there's the priest, paladin, warrior, hunter, shaman, and druid trainers here. If we talk to our paladin trainer, I am interested to see what he says. The light of the sun illuminates to the path to wisdom. Where shall we walk today, friend? And then we could do things like reset our class specialization. If we didn't want to be protection anymore, we could reset our talents if we didn't like stuff that we chose. You could reset glyphs and learn dual specialization, which allows me to be like a holy paladin as well as a prop paladin at different times. I can kind of swap over to them. Not something I'm really going to do right now. There is another quest over here, though. I am kind of interested to see what it is. I don't think I've ever really done the quests in this city, like, ever. There's an auctioneer over here? No way! No, I'm gonna sell my linen cloth that I got, everybody. A Tauren commoner. He doesn't even have a name. He's just a common cow. And that's a common cow. Wow. Wow, I bet this is gonna be an important quest. The festival is a time for fun and laughter. There's no mistake. It's important, however, that you understand the origins of this holiday. Education should be sought out and savored. The festival tailspinner and the Horde capitals can guide your way. Go now and learn. Oh, I guess this is talking about the summer fire festival that's going on right now. If you type /calendar in the game, that should work. Yeah, there we go. If you type /calendar in the game, you can see all the holidays that are happening. And the one going on right now is... I'm going to see it here somewhere, I swear. The Mid-Summer Fire Festival. I guess it just started on the 21st. Today's the 25th. It encourages you to go around the world and, like, do all kinds of stuff and interact with the world in different ways. And then you get rewarded for doing that. Which is kind of cool. But I haven't done any of it yet, so maybe we should go talk to this guy, this expert. Are they all the way up there, though? Oh, I have to go all the way back to the start. The alchemy supply place actually looks pretty cool. Wonder what's upstairs. How stairs work. I like how this place is wheelchair accessible, but they don't have handrails. This is pretty considerate of them. Holy crap, does this seriously take me to the top? Oh, yes. Did it? No, I think I need to go higher. What's this guy doing?
Relax.
I give you warm greetings, paladins, as does the shattered hand. Do not look so surprised, PallyTime. There be shadows even on the highest perches of Orgrimmar. Something must hide there. The shattered hand, take that role willingly. Thrall, even in his good heart, acknowledge that the hand be necessary to ensure orc and troll safety. But not here to talk about my business. You here for something else. No, I was just seeing what you were doing standing in this fucking tower with your goddamn daggers out, you weirdo. So he thinks he's some kind of ninja just because he walked up a wheelchair ramp. That's okay. I mean, whatever floats your boat, I guess. Weirdo. I think I found them. They're over here by all the portals. These were added in Cataclysm, and they take you to all the different regions. This is, I don't remember the name of the zone. Uldum, right? Yeah, this was Uldum. It's like a desert zone, kind of like Egypt. This one was a water zone. This one was in the middle of the earth. Some pretty cool stuff. This was Mount Hijaw. I don't remember what this one was, but it was like there's a big tower and a raid there. Looks like this tent is all set up for the festival that's happening. This is kind of cool. There's a portal to Tol Barad. No thanks. It's a PvP zone. Festival Tailspinner. That better be good. Enjoying the festival, Paladin? Well, I just got here. Some of your face is missing. Are you alarmed? While the flame keepers tend to the fires of the present, I am more of a historian, keeping close the festival's past. I'm also, of course, documenting the year's festivities. Things are going well thus far, don't you think? You know, PallyTime, there is power inherent in all festival fires burning throughout the holiday. We're taking care of ours, but I'm certain there are sacred flames burning deep within your enemy's cities. You motherfucker, what? You want me to go to enemy cities? Is that what you said? Let's see. This was our quest to come talk to him. We're gonna get a reward. I'll be happy to tell you what I know. We got a burning blossom. Use near a fire festival bonfire to receive the fire festival furry buff. I know it says fury, but it's funnier to say furry. Or to reignite the extinguished bonfire. These are also used as currency at the Midsummer Suppliers Merchant. Cool. And then he had another quest for me that I just totally skipped all the dialogue for. Did you know that our festival fires burn in every land with a horde settlement? Flame keepers tend to them in camps outside of each town, ensuring the bonfires are bright and the celebrations continue. Each flame keeper is a festival scorchling, an emissary to the elemental spirits of fire. Would you like to honor a scorchling, PallyTime? Take the summer incense and bring it to any festival scorchling. Appease the little fire spirit, and it may reward you. Okay, so they just want us to help, like, take part in the festivities. Okay. So this is one of the fires that the Alliance would try to come to put out. And we would be doing the same thing in their cities right now. So you want to be a fire juggler? Well, I don't think I've ever said that once in my entire life. And I think you're pushing off your emotions onto me right now. Do you have what it takes? The dexterity, the reflexes, the courage? If you think so, then let's give you a little practice. I never said yes to any of this. Take these torches and run near the bonfire. You'll see braziers with markers flashing above them. Toss a torch at the marked braziers. Be quick. Do it before the mark fades, if you want credit for that toss. High enough mark braziers before the time limit, then come back here for, or hit enough, excuse me, before the time limit, then come back here for your next lesson. I never agreed to any of this. Okay, so we just put a practice torch on our bar and then we just throw it at the marked things. Oh, I didn't get that one. Didn't get that one. Okay, this is hard. What does this have to do with juggling at all? This has nothing to do with juggling. How do I know? Is there? What's the time limit? There's no rules here. I'm just throwing sticks at other sticks. You didn't tell me any of the rules, asshole. Throw it there. Throw it there. No, that was good. I did it. Yeah. Well done. You'll be a fire juggler faster than the fuse on a ground flower. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, totally. I totally know what you mean. Now gird yourself. The next test is when things really heat up. Now that you can throw a torch, let's see if you can catch one. Take this stack of unlit torches, go to the bonfire, and throw a torch high into the air. Catch it before it hits the ground, then throw it back up. Catch four in a row, then come back to me. Careful. They're dangerous if they hit the ground, and don't miss any catches. If you do, then you have to go back to the bonfire and start over. Good luck. You're very enthusiastic for a guy who's getting me to do shit that I don't give a fuck about. I just want to be very clear about that. We got a new spell because we leveled up. We're now level 14. We have Flash of Light. This is a single target heal that we can cast without the need of Holy Power. Pretty easy, pretty straightforward. If we're missing health, we heal. So, in my inventory, I have Summer Incense and Unlit Torches. We need to juggle the We need to juggle the unlit torches. How do I... Oh, there's the shadow. Seriously? Did I catch it? So, I throw this thing out. Requires a midsummer bonfire, so I didn't catch it. Oh man, this is a pretty intense shadow over here. It's not fair. Okay, so we threw it. It's up in the sky. There it is. Okay. All right, I'll get it. We'll do it this time. I think I could just follow the shadow though, and everything will be fine. A bear just appeared next to me. Oh, I tossed it right back up in the air, and then missed the second one. This is hard. Why would I even want this? This seems totally unnecessary. Completely. Did that one just disappear? Oh no, there it is. Yep, didn't. Did it hurt me? Fire juggling is dangerous. Oh my god. Ah! Son of a bitch. Oh, I got it this time. I got it this time. It's gonna be mine. It's getting bigger. That means it's landing. There's one. Where'd it go? Where'd it fucking go? Oh god. This is impossible. I'm about to rage quit fire juggling. Let's try throwing it this way. Let's get away from these guys. It still goes to the right. Are you kidding me? I threw it left. Come on. Come on. We can do it. We're a goddamn holy cow. I did it. Hey. Yeah, that was easy. I could do that the whole time. That was no big deal at all. Well, I just noticed this guy standing there. Who are you? Ambassador of the Green Dragonflight. Lord Itheris? Green Dragonflight, their leader's Ysera, right? And this guy's just hanging out watching him. That's pretty cool, man. Oh, there's another balloon! Yeah. I wonder if all the balloons are up high like this. I think I already said that, though. We're gonna get this kid his balloon back. Although he had five of them. Kid, you let five balloons go? I mean, that seems a little excessive. I think you did it on purpose, and now you just want your balloons back because you don't have any more to let go. I'm going to do a circle here, though, and see if we can find any. There's another one. Yes. I don't think I've ever really been up here. This is the back door to Orgrimmar. This is where all the trolls hang out. They live in their little huts down there. I've never actually stood up here to appreciate it. It's kind of cool. Oh, it actually doesn't connect over here. But next to this guy running in place, we got another balloon. That's over by the flight master. Well, that's going to be a little bit of a walk. Let's go turn in our fire juggling quest. That I nailed the first try with my eyes closed. Duh. Everybody saw it. Right? If you guys have been wondering what this little thing above the head of pets are, I guess I can go ahead and show you really quick. WoW, I think in Mist of Pandaria, added in the pet battle system. So this is a spiny lizard. It's level 1. And we can fight it. We can go in with my pets and we can battle this thing. I got a little baby Winston because I play that Overwatch game. I guess my chat comes back up when I'm in here. That's kind of a weird bug. But I have 3 abilities and then some extra stuff I can do. So because he's Winston, of course, he can put down a dome shield to protect himself for the next 2 turns. Or kind of reduce the damage he takes. Then he can enrage, which increases the damage he deals and the damage he takes. And then he can attack. Yeah. Because baby Winston's so strong, he killed it in one go. Also, I have a little baneling there too. That's a system that I never tried, like I never messed around with at all until I started playing again this time with Jessica, because Jessica loves pet battling. So while she's pet battling, I'll go around and I'll pet battle too. And I've actually been having some fun with it. If you're wondering what this is right here, it's actually the... It's too soon. I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to talk about it. It's too soon.
Did you get burned? If you did, then maybe you'll think twice before playing with fire. You told me to do this! I'm not playing! Just kidding. You fucking... Why aren't you a troll? You're an orc. You should act like it. Well done. It's official. You're a bona fide fire juggler. Now get out there and have some fun.
Okay, so we got more of these torch blossoms thing. He has another quest for us in regards to the festival. These are daily quests that I can repeat. That I can repeat every day. I don't think I'm going to do that. I don't know why these guys are spinning here. I legitimately have no idea. But I need to make my way over here. Oh, there's one too. There's a balloon right here. So when we go to the flight path, that'll be all of them. That'll be everything. There we go. That guy's still running in place, huh? How do you even run in place here? There's not even an invisible wall. Dude, my guild's full of hackers. I wonder if he's there. Let's try to communicate with him. Hello. How are you running in place? Okay. I'm just gonna take this balloon. And I guess I'll leave my guildie there. He's probably stuck in purgatory. She's probably stuck in purgatory and I should help. Don't worry. Actually worry. Yeah, I can't fucking do anything for you. You're stuck. I'm sorry. Can I land in the water and not die? Oh, I guess there's no reason to. That's right, there's a lift right here. This fucking thing. I never knew it was here. I'm so tilted. That's a nice mount, buddy. Yeah, that's much easier than just jumping. I think I would have hit the ground pretty hard here. Yeah. That wouldn't have been healthy for me. Hey, kid! Hey! I got your balloons! I did the thing for you! Did you find all my balloons, mister? Yeah. This is great! You did it! Thanks, mister! Oh, we got a horde balloon. I don't think I have one of those. Oh, no! He's... Where are you going? Yeah, I just let him go again. Just let him go again. It's okay. It's okay. Well, maybe one of those wyvern riders will pick him up or whatever these things are called. Oh, that poor kid. He's gonna die. It's like the movie Up, but really sad. And he left his pet behind. He left Spooks behind. Oh, no. He said something. What'd he say? This is great. He just disappeared. He went so high that I can't see him anymore. And he left Spooks behind. Oh, no. All right. Well, we have a horde balloon. Teaches you how to summon this companion. The littlest pet shop. What is that? ...150 pets! Oh! Let's see, let's summon it. So this is my pet collection. Horde balloon. You know, you can use this as a battle pet. Isn't that hilarious? Oh my god, I can use it right now. Oh, can I not? Oh, this creature cannot battle. Never mind, I take it back. Oh, look at it! It just kind of sticks onto my arm! And then I carry it around with me. That's so cool! Dude, I got so hardcore distracted. Now, where's the jewel crafting guy? There's a dead man in town. Here, let's res him. I wouldn't feel right if I just left this guy dead on the ground. We can bring him back to life. With our little horde balloon. Oh my god, did he actually accept it? Because that...
Oh, I'll heal you! Come here! I only you 180 at a time. But don't worry, mister, we'll get you back up to full health real soon. We'll get you back up to full health in no time.
2,000 years later.
He's almost there. Be careful, mister. He said thank you. Oh, we're so nice. We're nice as fuck. We're a holy cow.
So again, if you ever want to find something in like a reasonable amount of time, just go up to a guard and be like, hey, I want to find a professions trainer. And he'll be like, which fucking profession do you want, asshole? Be more specific. And I'll be like, jewel crafting, please. And he's like, here, give me your map. I'll fucking scribble on it. But that scribble magically goes away later on. So the jewel crafter is actually in the Valley of Honor. We haven't been there yet. I guess I'll make my way over there now. Toys and novelties. Hold on. I want to look. Oh, why is it all so, it's all so expensive? You know what? I'll come back later. Thank you.
He just
legitimately asked me if I was interested in a payment plan. When I said everything was too expensive. Oh, that's good stuff. These quests over here on these boards, this is like helping to direct you to an area. So for instance, I'm within the level range of the Northern Barrens. So they'll give me a quest to go to the Northern Barrens or, you know, any other level that's appropriate for us. And that'll constantly update. So if you're ever wondering where to go, what the fuck is going on here? Red Canyon mining and jewel crafting. This is everything I need all in one spot. This is the mining trainer. Okay, so there's no dialogue. I just say I want to be a miner. How to pull ore and stone from mineral veins for use in engineering and blacksmithing. Gives potential mining skill of 75. Well, this is outdated. But okay, yeah, I would love to learn mining. And then we need to find the mining supplies, which is this beautiful woman over here. And we need to buy a mining pick. Awesome. So we're good to go there. We should probably buy the jewel crafter's kit as well, just to get started. I don't know what any of that other stuff is. And then the jewel crafting trainer is right here. And jewel crafting allows a jewel crafter to make jewelry up to a maximum potential of 75. Requires precious gems and metals gathered with the mining skill. But remember, mining doesn't actually help in jewel crafting, everybody. So we have my two professions. Those are good to go. We should probably get first aid at some point too. But, you know, we can do that later. How jewel crafting works is you hit P. And then you go to the top, or maybe, I don't know, you go to professions, and then this is everything you can make with jewel crafting. So I can make these copper rings that give one spirit, woven copper thing gives one intellect, and basically I can make this stuff so I can equip it and make my character better. Or, you know, that's the goal. The last building I wanted to show you guys, I'm sure there's more notable buildings in here, don't get me wrong. Last building I wanted to show you guys was the barber shop. We could sit down in the chair. Really? Is that chair just not fit for Tauren? Or are they all like that? They're all like that? I'm just too big? We can kind of see me here. Anyway, you could change like your all of your facial features, like your actual face, which is incredibly disturbing to me. Your skin color. That one I can understand a little bit more for a bullvine. Then you could also change your horn structure, which is also terrifying. I think that's incredibly disturbing. Your horn color, you know, you can kind of dye your horns, right? I don't think that's big of a deal. But then you can also change your facial hair. And it's pretty cheap, so I thought I would go for a different look today. I thought I would cut it a little short to represent how I look in real life right now. And then you get an achievement for it. A super serious achievement. Just for cutting your hair. Thank you. Alright, the last place I wanted to show you. My favorite place in Orgrimmar. By the way, question of the day has to be, what is your favorite city in the World of Warcraft?
Now, Orgrimmar is not my favorite city, but this is my favorite place. This is the Cleft of Shadows. This place has always been dark and gloomy and a completely different tone than the entirety of the city. This is where the rogues hang out. This is where the rogue trainers are. This is where the warlock trainers are. This is where you can learn to make poison. This is a sketchy fucking part of town. Not only that, but there's a portal here that leads you to the goddamn gate that Illidan came out of or went into or however that works. I don't know. Burning Crusade. This is not a place you want to be caught in the middle of the night. This is the sketchy fucking part of town. I just like it because it's not as bright and I like dark places. There's a guy down here that will teach you about demons. Like, that's the kind of fucked up place you just stumbled into. But more importantly, down here is the first dungeon accessible to anyone in the game. It is called Ragefire Chasm, and I'm going to be doing it in the next video. I know I said at the beginning that this video would be a little different. It's not really story-driven. It's just kind of me walking around town and doing odds and ends. But, you know, it's important to do that as well. Maybe it won't get the best reception from you guys, but I hope you enjoyed it nonetheless. In the next video, I'm going to knock out this dungeon. Actually, let's go inside really quick and make sure I can get the quests. If I cannot get the quests, then we'll figure something out. I don't know, actually. I cannot get the quests. We'll see if I can kill stuff. If I can kill stuff, then I'll just get to 15 and then reset them and we'll do the quests in the next video. Let's see. So I'm going to try to solo this at level 14. I don't know if it's possible. It's pretty slow. I can already tell you that. Let's throw our spear at it, or our shield. That did stuff. We're not really taking a whole ton of damage. We're also not dealing a whole ton of damage. But yeah, this is looking doable. I think I could solo this. And it's not going to take very long for me to actually hit level 15 just by killing these guys. As you can see, this bar is moving up quite a bit. So I'm going to go ahead and get my little Tauren up to level 15. And then in the next video, we will venture through the depths of Ragefire Chasm. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you all next time.